हेलो फ्रेंड, वेलकम बैक टू माय न्यू लेक्चर ऑन वेब सर्विसेज। वेब सर्विसेज इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट ऑफ ASP.NET एंड दिस इज यूज फॉर डिफाइनिंग डिजाइनिंग एक्सटर्नल वेब सर्विसेज एंड दीज वेब सर्विसेज आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड यू कैन सी द डेफिनेशन ऑफ दिस वेब सर्विसेज इन दिस फर्स्ट पैराग्राफ। वेब सर्विसेज आर द वेब एप्स दैट रिटर्न डेटा नॉट प्रेजेंटेशन। मीन्स वेब सर्विसेज आर द जस्ट लाइक ए फंक्शन दीज एप्स like Android app and there are many different types of app. So they return data, not presentation. Since application are typically about accessing data, web services are poised to become next evolutionary step in distributed software development. So in this new era of the software technology, so these web services are very, very important. They are typically about to accessing data. So you can see here the diagram where we have database, and through the different object and through different services we are collecting the data, accessing the data, and this data is through web browser we are sending back to the user. So somehow we can say these web services are the cross application development and legacy of the system integration, part of the system integration. So, I am giving one case study or one example of this web services. Maybe this definition is not so clear. So, I am explaining this one through this example. Google, whenever we search on Google is the example. So, this is for search, a great search engine, one of the biggest and one of the most popular search engine till now, and it is based on GUI based now based, and we can also develop our search engine also. So so we need lots of programming for that. So this is the one of the example that Google is searching anything, the phrase we are giving to the Google. So Google offers a web services that perform searches for you. So this is also very important line. Google offers a web service that performs searches for you. So it performs the web services. It runs the web services to search anything. So understand this line. So now as we have given the search string, accordingly it will search and it will display the message. It will return the data. So you can see here some small code of program, part of program. Like this is Google search service. Suppose this is the class Google search service. So we have taken a object of this class Google equals to new Google search service, and the result, and another object is result. Result is equals to Google dot this Google, this one, this object, Google object dot do Google search. So we are writing here do Google search. So whatever we will pass to this parameter will pass accordingly, it will move here, and say here txt search text data. Suppose this is the text box and txt search dot text, and this is our other parameter. So by this command we are running the search function or search web services. And then after getting the result, we will access all the result, we'll retrieve all the result in this result object, and then we'll run the for each. Through for each we will display all the search indexes. So result element re is the object of the result element class in result. So from result, result element, there are many result elements inside the result, this result, and one by one this for each loop we are transferring this to re, and then re dot url we are displaying the url, first url dot items dot add re dot. So this is the in this grid box we will display these urls. So first urls dot items dot add. So this one we will add here, and then we will find all the different links of this search. So this is somehow this is the example of Google web services. So now how we'll create the web services. This is the example of Google for web services. So again you can see here, web services are the web app that return data, not presentation, that return data. So this way here we are getting the result, we are accessing the all the result in using Google's web service. So Google's web service, it is the heading here in this slide. So now how to create the web services. So first of all, when we will start the new project, and inside new project we will find ASP.NET website, as well as we will find ASP.NET web services. So we have to select ASP.NET web services. So as we will click on this ASP.NET web services, and then this is ASP.NET web services. Start by creating project type ASP.NET web services. I have indicated this by arrow. As we will click on this, and then we will come on to the new window, and you can see here like that we will have this window, and in this window we have everything. We have namespace, web services namespace, web service binding. This is the this is the default template, and it will be displayed here, and we have to write our code inside this service, or inside this service we have different method. So we have given here, this is default method, hello world is the default method, and we can change this method. We can delete this hello world function, and we can place our function inside this class, service class. So this is the predefined template, and it will be displayed as you will click on the ASP.NET web service here. So ye humko ye bana banaya template aayega jisme humko code likhna hai. So this is ASP.NET web services. So one or more object that respond to web-based method call, there is no GUI design to a web service. So only raw class will with the method. So as we will click on ASP.NET web services, it will display this window, and on left side of the window, on the left side of the window we will find Solution Explorer, and in Solution Explorer we have this service one dot. The default name of the web service is service one. In case of console application, the default name is console application one. In case of window application, it will be window programming, it will be window application one. And in case of web services, it will be public class service one, and we can change service one to other name also. And it will be inherited by the system.web.services.webservices. So this is also default class. So always web service class will be inherited by this class. So colon will be there, and you can see the file name of this default file name of this web service, service1.asmx, in Solution Explorer window. So now I'm coming on the program. So this is the default program. It will be template, default template. It will be displayed on the window. Now suppose we have to add this code. So this is the code. This is the piece of code where we have written a simple function. This is add function, and add inside the add function we have written here x and y, two argument, and by adding these argument we are returning it. So this is two argument. So this is service, and you can see here this is service function, and this is hello world function, and inside the public class service we have hello world function, but in place of hello world, or in addition to hello world, we are writing this function also. And this is one of the function, attendee function, attendees function, and its return type is the string. So this is array. So it will return multiple element. So the attribute of this function is web method. This is web services method. So we have to write here web method, its attribute, and it is inherited by the system.web.service.webservice. So it will be automatically, it will come on the program. तो ये प्रोग्राम का पार्ट है. हमको क्या करना है, ये प्रोग्राम इस तरह से जो हमारी विंडो आएगी, ये प्रोग्राम, ये विंडो हमारी डिस्प्ले होगी, ये कंप्लीट विंडो यूजिंग स्टेटमेंट के साथ ये कंप्लीट विंडो होगी. हमको क्या करना है कि यहाँ पे हेलो वर्ड के साथ ये हेलो वर्ड को हटा दें, इसको डिलीट कर सकते हैं, या फिर हम एक नया फंक्शन एड फंक्शन उसमें ऐड कर दिया है. तो हमने वी आर राइटिंग दिस फंक्शन एज वेल एज दिस फंक्शन. तो हम इस तरह से हम कर रहे हैं इसमें. तो ये एडिशनल फंक्शन है, दिस इज एडिशनल फंक्शन. सो लुक लाइक सी शार्प, दिस प्रोग्रामिंग इज लुक लाइक सी शार्प बिकॉज इट्स पार्ट ऑफ सी शार्प प्रोग्रामिंग, बट कीप इन माइंड दीज आर वेब बेस्ड मेथड एंड क्लाइंट कुड बी दीज आर द वेब बेस्ड मेथड एंड वी हैव मेंशनड हियर ये दीज आर द एट्रीब्यूट्स द फंक्शन एट्रीब्यूट्स मीन्स वी आर डिफाइनिंग दैट दिस इज वेब सर्विस मेथड वेब मेथड वी हैव डिफाइंड हियर and web-based methods and client could be calling from any platform and in any this is the feature this is the specialty of web services and parameter passed using XML and we'll use XML for parameters so I will show you by the diagram in the next slide so how parameter are passed through the XML how the process is the complete process is going on this in case of this web services So this is the function and now I am coming on the next it's window application it's a window it's output so how we'll write the output so now you can see this one also this is the output of the program as we have given this code So for this code we need this output this is the output window so how we'll display this output window so we have to write this program you can see here we have two text boxes one for first variable and second one for second variable and we have one button and this is the output this will show the output this is the text area where we can display the output so these are two text boxes and we have in the function we have two variable x and y so the value of first text box will be passed to x and second text box will be passed to y so accordingly we have the output window so now see the output window the program output window program this is the program of the vb.net we are not writing it in C#.net so private sub button 1 underscore click so this is button sorry this is button 1 so as we will click on the button 1 this function will execute and handles button 1 underscore click so we will write here event also and we have defined here I j k as integer three integer variable defined here and the text box 1 dot text and text box 2 dot text these two text box value will be converted into integer c integer in case of the c sharp we'll write here in case of java we'll write here percent but here we will write c capital c and capital I and t so it will convert it into integer and I and j are the integer variable so the text box value will be converted into integer value why we are converting to integer because we have to add these two values so we have defined here dim obj as local host dot service one obj is the object dim obj object as service one local host dot service so why we are writing here local host dot service one so again you can see the program service one is the name of web service so we are defining the object of service one and this service one is inside localhost so see this service one is inside our server if the server is remote server then we will write the name of the server so but this server is the remote is our server is local server so that's why we are writing here localhost dot service one so you have to understand this we have to write here localhost suppose server is remotely located then we will write the name of server agar server kahin dur hai kisi aur location pe koi dusra system hai to hum yahan pe server ka address likhenge server ka name likhenge but agar hamara hi computer hai to then we will write here localhost.service1 so we have defined the object of the class and this is obj equals to obj it's a type obj as localhost.service1 so now we will define the object properly obj equals to new localhost dot service one so we have defined object of this class so again see the class we have defined object of this class so regardless of the location of this function, this web service may be located anywhere. It may be in our computer as well as it may be located in a remote server. So, but we will define the object of that service one, and then we will write obj.add I, j, these ij, in ij we have the value of text1 and text2. These value, text1 value and text2 value are accordingly transferred to the I and j variable. And these I and j variable are passed to the add function. And add function is a part of obj. And obj equals to new localhost dot service1. Again, see the program. So this is service one, and inside service one we have function add, and its argument x and y. So I and j are transferred to the x and y. So I will be transferred to x and j will transfer to y. So x plus y means sum of I or I plus j. So this is sum of these two, and then we will have k and two message box dot source sum equals to k, this is k dot to string. So whatever the value we have returned, the sum of these two value means 30 will return, and 30 will be converted into string form, so that message box will be print the string value, not integer value. So we will return here, we have written here k dot to string. So it will print the value of k in message box after clicking on this sum function. So this is the way how we are running the web services, and this is localhost, and we will write type URL for the web service, localhost dot web service dot service one, and this is web server name, this is service name, and this is class name. This is the web service name, and this is the class name. Inside the web service we have this is inside web service file, so we'll have this one. So these are two. So as usual we need to reference of the component. So when we will execute the program, so we will write here add reference, and in add reference we will mention this service one. So you can see here project reference, right click on add web reference, this is add web, not add reference. We have to click on add reference, right click on reference, then we will write we will have this these two tabs. So we will have to press on add web reference and type URL for web service. So we will write this web service, so it will be add on this program at this window, with this window, and as this will be the part of this object window, we can say it is object window. So this way we will run the web services, and how the working of the web services, you can see this diagram. Basically client send method call, and the proxy server will send the SOAP message, means XML message, and in the form of into web services web server, and in web server we have ASMX file, and then method will be called, accordingly WSDL will send the result. So this is the whole process of the web technology, how to run the web services. So you can see again, this is the example. As client will request, you can see here, as the client will request obj.add, we have the function obj.add. So you can see here, this is obj.add, and it is here method call. Initially we are client will method call. So you can see here obj.add I, j. obj.add I, j. This is obj.add ij, and add ij, add is this function, service one. This is the part of service one. So add ij, I will be transferred on x and y, ij will be transferred on y, and this obj is the object of localhost service one. So that's why we are writing here add, add obj1 dot add. So this is method call, basically this is method call. sent to proxy server, and then XML will be executed. You can see here, then SOAP message XML will be executed. So these value INJ inside INJ we have 10 and 20. These values are inside INJ. Means text 1, the value of text 1 is transferred to I, and text 2 value is transferred to the J. So 10 and 20 are INJ, and these IJ will transfer to through XML. So this HTTP request is converted into XML. So you can see here, add is the outer tag element, and inside add is a function. Again see the function name is add. So add is the outer tag, and the variable I and j, they are n1 and n2. They will be n1 and n2. This will be HTML file, and this HTML request will transfer to the web server. And here in web server we have service one. We have the method service one. Service one is the service one is the web services. You can see here service one SOAP XML, and web server we have ASMX file. This is service one file. This is service one file. You can see here, this is service one file. This one is the service one file. This is service one. So this is service one. So we'll execute service one on this. In web services we are running HTTP request service one dot ASMX, and in service one these 10 and 20 will be transferred to the X and Y. And obj.add 10 and 20. Here we are writing a variable INJ, but now we have data 10 and 20. Then 10 and 20 will execute. And finally, we will return the result in the form of WSDL. So I will explain you what is WSDL, how it will be executed. So this way we are running the program. This way we are running the program. In this case we have this message box dot so 2 dot k dot 2 string. So it will display the output. So in the form of WSDL it will return to the client. So this is whole process of this web services. So web services invoke many technologies. So in while running this web service, we require lots of services, lots of technology, WS, to learn about the web service. So we have to learn web service and WSDL also. So in my next lecture, I will explain you how to use WSDL or SOAP or XML. I have already explained you. So the proxy object, SOAP, XML, HTTP, ASMX. So we have different points and different technology which we need to learn for running this web services. So I have explained you how to execute this web service, and here what the call to add actually looks like, or how to add run this add function. Very simple add function, but the process is very long process to execute this add function. So web services are very important part of this technology, ASP.NET technology. It is very important and integral part of ASP.NET technology, and presently web services are used for running different web technology, and Google is one of the most popular example of this web services. So guys, thank you very much for listening this lecture, and please subscribe this channel, subscribe my channel, and don't forget to push bell icon on my channel. Thank you.